Well, we're going to go now to the Delta COVID variant, and it's considered a more dangerous coronavirus strain, but it's not the only variant that has scientists concerned. So joining us now with more information about this is our chief health editor, Dr. Partha Nandy. Good afternoon, Dr. Nandy.
Afternoon, Glenda. How are you?
Doing fine, thank you. We know all eyes have been on this Delta, but what other variant is troubling?
Yeah, this is, we're going to keep getting this, unfortunately, until we get this controlled. The Delta variant was first identified in India, as we know, definitely has been making headlines and gaining ground, not just in the U.S., but in many other countries, Glenda. And that's because the Delta variant is roughly 60% more infectious and can cause more severe disease. But it's not the only strain, right? The CDC has deemed a variant of concern. The Gamma variant that was first detected in Brazil, also called the P1 variant, is also gaining ground in the U.S. And just like the Delta variant, Glenda, the Gamma variant is more transmissible. In fact, the CDC's variant tracker shows that the Gamma variant is greater than 15% in many areas in the U.S. alone, and it can be found in every state that the CDC tracks data in, which is not good. And I think this is very concerning because this particular variant has caused over 500,000 deaths in Brazil alone. So that's not good at all.
So Doc, evidence is showing that the Gamma variant is more resistant to antibody treatments and to vaccines. So how concerned should we be about this?
So let me just say this, Glenda, the Gamma variant is not the only variant that's been shown to be less responsive to antibody treatments. The Delta variant has also showed greater resistance. As for vaccine, now research has indicated that these variants are antibody resistant could also cause issue for vaccines like Johnson & Johnson's, the one-shot dose, right? While there's not a lot of data on the J&J's vaccine, experts do believe this, that it'll still be effective and keep people out of the intensive care unit, which is what really we want vaccines to do. And as far as the two-dose vaccines, like the Pfizer and the Moderna that a lot of us have received, including myself, it's expected that those vaccines, right, will handle the variants quite well because of their potency and very high efficacy rates. So once again, I'm saying this again and again, broken record, vaccines are our best shot from keeping these variants in check, keeping more people from getting severely ill and possibly dying from COVID. And if you've had COVID and recovered, it doesn't mean that everything is great. You're still not, may not be protected against the variants. Studies have shown that reinfection can happen. So be sure to get fully vaccinated. Let's keep those variants really boxed in, reined in, and leave little room for them to evolve into something that's possibly more dangerous than what we're dealing with. Now we'll keep an eye on this Gamma variant and give you more news as it comes. But again, we've got to get vaccinated so we can rein these variants in. That's the bottom line.
Still have to stay safe out there. Dr. Nandy, thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you.
And if you have a coronavirus question for the good doctor, you can email him at drnandy@askdrnandy.com. Or send it to us on Facebook or Twitter, and we'll get it right to him, Alan.